Dear student, standard 9, Assalamu alaikum. Hope you are fine by the grace of Allah. Today I will start a new chapter, that is chapter 7, lecture 1.
So, the chapter's name is The Organs of Bangladesh Government and the Administrative System. At first, what is government? Government is the basic controlling power of the state. A state performs its all activities by centering it. It is like an engine of a ship. Government makes laws to maintain peace and order of the state and to regulate the people, abide by all legal order of the government and express loyalty towards the government. Now, organs of the government. There are three organs of the government. Legislative, that means Ain Bibhag. Executive, that means Shashan Bibhag. And Judiciary, that means Bichar Bibhag. This is the picture of Jatiyo Sangshad Bhavan. This is the picture of Supreme Court. And this is the picture of Bangladesh Secretariat, that means the pictures of three organs. And I will discuss about these three organs in this class. So at first, legislature. What is legislature? The legislature is composed of persons elected by the people or members nominated in some particular extent. Every state has a legislative body with different names, like Bangladesh, the name of legislature is the Parliament. USA, the Congress. UK, the Parliament. Different Muslim countries, Majlis. Australia, Federal Parliament or Commonwealth Parliament. Maldives, the People's Majlis. Then, Russia, the Federal Assembly. India, Parliament. Japan, the National Diet. Saudi Arabia, the Consultative Assembly of Saudi Arabia, or Majlis as Shura or Shura Council. Okay, and it is the formal advisory body of the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, which is an absolutely monarchy. That means Saudi Arabia, the legislature is not like the other countries. And in here, voting system, none. That means no voting system, but appointment by the king. That means the head of the state appointed by the king. Now, there are some countries which have unicameral and some have bicameral legislature. Like Bangladesh has unicameral legislature, and unicameral means there is only one parliament or unitary form of government. In India, there are bicameral or federal government system exist. That means two separate parliament. And a bicameral parliament consists of an upper house and a lower house. Okay, this is the picture of the lower house of India and this is the picture of upper house of India. Now, I have given some picture of different countries' parliament. This is the parliament picture of USA. This is the picture of outside. And this is the inner side of the parliament, okay? Parliament of UK. Here is B means bicameral. USA has also the bicameral parliament. Maldives, U means unicameral or unitary form of government. So thereof, this is monarchy. Japan, bicameral. Australia, bicameral. Nepal, also bicameral. Okay, I have given some examples of unitary form of government. That means there are some countries in where the unitary form of government or unicameral form of government exists, like Albania, Angola, Armenia, Azerbaijan, Bangladesh. Then here is Brunei, Botswana, Maldives, etc. Okay, but Saudi Arabia and Vatican City do not have a separate legislative body. This is the picture of legislature. So the name of our legislature is National Assembly or Jatiyo Sangsad. Here is total member 350, and it is situated at Shere Bangla Nagar in Bangladesh, capital of Dhaka. Construction started 1961 and construction completed 1982 and cost $32 million. Architects is main Louis Khan and co-architect is Mazharul Islam. Jatiyo Sangsad Bhavan or National Parliament House is the house of the Parliament of Bangladesh. And the construction was started in 1961 when Bangladesh was East Pakistan and led by Ayub Khan from the West Pakistan capital of Islamabad. Now, the formation of the legislature. The name of our legislature is Jatiyo Sangsad. It is unicameral. It consists of 350 members. Among them, 300 members are elected from 300 constituencies, and 50 female members, that means from reserve seat, are elected by the 300 MPs, that means member of the parliament. There is one speaker and one deputy speaker in the parliament. The speaker conducts all activities relating to the session of the parliament. The deputy speaker conducts the parliamentary session in absence of a speaker. Both of them are elected from among the members of the parliament by their vote. Shirin Sharmin Chowdhury is the current speaker who presides over the 11th Jatiyo Sangsad, and deputy speaker Fazle Rabbi Mia. Shirin Sharmin Chowdhury and Fazle Rabbi Mia, present speaker and present deputy speaker.
Now, functions of legislature. At first, it enacts and amends general laws of the country. Number two, it ventilates and expresses public opinion. Number three, it controls government income and expenditure. Number four, it formulates and amends the constitution. Five, if any allegation is raised against the president, it takes this into consideration. Six, it plays an important role as a guardian of our national exchequer. Seven, it approves the budget and collects the taxes. In standard 8, I have discussed a lot on this function, isn't it? So, let's watch a video on legislature, that means on Jatiyo Sangsad.
Thank you.
Thank you everyone for watching the video. Okay, now here is a tree of three organs of the government: executive, legislative and judiciary. Now I will explain the executive and judiciary. Now what is executive? A smooth administration system is must for the internal peace, discipline and development of a country. The administration is the department that regulates governance of the state, that means conducts the regular and occasional administrative and official functions, maintains law and order, and implements overall resolutions of the state, the privileges. In greater sense, the executive or the administration department consists of all administrative employees, including the president, the cabinet, the government officials, the security, law and order maintaining agencies, the diplomats, the officers altogether. Not only that, a village chowkidar or watchman is also a part of the executive, and it is in narrow sense. The name of the administrative headquarters of the government of Bangladesh is the Bangladesh Secretariat, and it is also known as Bangladesh Sochibalay. I have given the picture of Bangladesh Secretariat or Sochibalay. Okay. Now, the Bangladesh Secretariat, also known as Bangladesh Sochibalay, I have told, or old secretariat, and it is the administrative headquarters of the government of Bangladesh and houses of the majority of ministries and government agencies and bodies. Location: Dhaka, Bangladesh. Address: Abdul Ghani Road, Dhaka 1000. And it construction started 1947 and completed 1969. Now I will explain the judiciary. This is the logo of judiciary. This is the picture of Supreme Court. This is also the in front of the Supreme Court. Okay, so judiciary, that means the organ which administers impartial judgment according to the law of the country is called judiciary. The judiciary consists of the judges of all the courts of Bangladesh. The Supreme Court is the highest court of justice in the judicial department. The chief of this department is called the Chief Justice. The president appoints the Chief Justice. And the Supreme Court has two divisions: Appellate Division and High Court Divisions. Okay, and in Appellate Divisions and High Court Divisions, there are also justice, and both justice also appointed by the president. The main function of the judiciary is to punish the infringers of the law. Infringers, that means who? Lawbreakers. Establish justice and protect individual freedom of the citizens. Okay, and in the next class I will discuss elaborately function of the judiciary. Okay, so today up to this everyone, thank you.